So some of you may or may not know who the famous world heavyweight champion WWE wrestler known as Logan Paul is. But before he was a WWE wrestler, he was this really cringe dude on this app called Vine. Back from my childhood, yes, I know, Lofi is unk status now. And whenever Vine finally shut down and Logan was out of a job, he didn't know what to do. So he did the next best thing. He hopped over onto the great app known as YouTube. And he had a great stint on YouTube, alright? He did some stuff, got in some controversies. He had some weird stuff happen in a forest and a dead body. I honestly don't know what that was all about. Apparently it was a big deal. I don't know. He made this whole apology video.
I've made a severe and continuous lapse in my judgment, and I don't expect to be forgiven.
But apparently, he didn't make a severe lapse of judgment that he learned from. Alright, he came back from YouTube a year later after this video, and we thought he was a changed man. Logan's public perception was actually pretty decent for a while, but then there's this whole thing with, like, this, like, crypto lawsuit that's going on right now, but we can forget about that right now, okay? I'm not trying to get sued, too. Now, eventually, homeboy Logan somehow got to be doing RKOs with Randy Orton. I don't know how that worked. He somehow slithered his way into the WWE, getting pounded by oiled up men in Speedos, got his own energy drink called Prime, and you think that, you know, this man on top of the world, having done every side quest possible for an internet man, but it would be enough that he has enough attention, enough fame, enough news articles written about him every other week every time he sneezes and jerks off. But no, he had to go one step further and almost kill his dog for views. Yeah, I'm not even joking, bro. There's this video resurfacing from like 4 years ago that's just, it's popping off on Twitter right now. Everybody's talking about it, where people are debating whether or not he actually threw his dog underneath a boat so he could go fake save it for attention and views. Let me just roll the clip. Yeah, it for real looks like he deadass just pushed the dog into the ocean. Like, I don't know if you guys know what happens if you get stuck under a boat and the propellers are spinning, but you literally get turned into a smoothie. You know, I'd say I'd be surprised that Logan's willing to turn his dog into a mincemeat slushy just for some views, but I'm honestly not. Like, how evil do you gotta be to risk an animal's life for some content, bro? Jesus, fuck. Dogs are supposed to be man's best friend, not man's best content farm. Oh my god. I've been making moves, trying to lay low. Just for 20k, all in pesos. Yeah, I'ma get baby K to no Range Rogue. Off the mids, give me high like a K-pop. And I'm smoking on that Terminator. Oh, yeah, I forgot, I gotta like start the video now and shit. Yo, how's it going, broskis? It's your boy Lofi here. And yeah, Logan Paul is doing some stuff again. Logan's just one of those YouTubers where you only really hear anything about them the second that they do some like f***ed up shit. You know, those people that are never really like up in the news or being talked about. It's not because they, I don't know, planted a million trees like Mr. Beast. It's not because they built an orphanage or they saved a kid from a fire. It's because they're sacrificing animals to the YouTube gods. Like, why can't it be YouTuber found with a pound of weed at airport? He was trying to smuggle it into Cambodia. Like, never. It's always something about like people dying or something or someone getting abused. Why are YouTubers doing drugs again? YouTube was so much cooler and everybody was on acid and making story times about it. Like, even when they're the ones who were lying about it. Like, at least the stories are entertaining. But nah, now we gotta figure out whether or not Logan Paul legitimately was trying to make a puppy smoothie. And as I'm actively recording this, he's actually responded on Twitter saying, I would never, with a screenshot from 4 years ago on like a video about this, talk about he would never do this. I would never kill my dog for content. I'll film dead bodies. Real human dead bodies in forests. I'll scam people. I'll scam my fans. All right. I'll sue people for investigating me, but I won't kill dogs. All right. That's where I draw the line. And then he replied to the tweet with an HD version of the video, like with some editing showing, hey, there was actually two different people trying to pet the dog and stabilize the dog. It jumped on its own. I mean, and the thing is, I don't even know if I believe him or not. Like, genuinely, this guy has been in so much shit and done so much like up stuff that of course everybody's immediate reaction is, oh, he's just trying to cover for his WWE deal. Yeah, of course it'll look bad for Prime and his podcast. Either way though, it doesn't matter if the dog was pushed or not. The fact that at the beginning of the video you can hear him saying, no, don't do it, don't do it, while filming the dog actively about a jump shows that either way he was filming what was about to happen for content. It was obvious the dog was thinking about jumping, and instead of being like, hey, stop the boat right now before the dog jumps, we can secure low homie, they let homie jump, kept the boat going, knowing most likely the dog was gonna, you know, jump and, you know, something crazy could have happened. It's not like he let stuff happen, you know, for videos and stuff in the past just so he could get a good clip. Not to bring up old stuff, but the Suicide Forest thing was allegedly not scripted. They didn't find that dead body and then turn the cameras back on. Apparently that just randomly happened, the same way that this dog just randomly jumped. Even though in the video you can clearly see that they knew, bro. They knew. All right, let me show you guys the full clip. Hold on.
Probably don't do it. No, not in the front.
Not yet.
Oh, no. Oh no, please. Oh no. Broly, I'm going in. Come here, buddy. Bro, what the fuck?
I haven't been scared like this in a while.
I can't have you doing that. No more of that, okay? We're in the middle of a lake. You're used to swimming in a pool in Encino. There's a big difference, okay? Take it easy from now on. Promise me.
Now, odd enough, the clip that has been splooged onto everybody's eyeballs via Twitter doesn't even have the part where they're saying, Riley, don't do it. Oh, no, don't do it, bro. Logan posted that himself. Of him waiting for the dog to jump, putting the camera in its face, and then acting so surprised when it jumped and almost got cut in half by the boat propeller. So congratulations, Logan. At this point, it doesn't even matter whether or not somebody pushed the dog. The fact that you waited for it to happen, knowing full well you could have stopped the boat before homie jumped and then safely secured Lil Bro, just shows that you were willing to possibly let it happen for some views. So either way, Logan still comes out of the situation just looking like a huge piece of shit who only cares about views, fame, money, and Prime. Yeah, dude, Prime. It's all about Prime. That's it. He needs the Prime sales up. He has to show that he's a dog lover. He's trying to reach the dog lover demographic, all right? He's trying to reach the furries. Not enough furries are buying Prime, so now he has to show that he really loves huskies by faking a scenario where he saves one. So to all my furry homies out there, do not buy the Prime. All right, I am preaching to you. Logan Paul's trying to get in your brains. Do not fall for his trickery. Do not buy Prime just because he saved a doggy.
In all seriousness, though, right, like, all jokes and memes aside, genuinely, I don't get how him posting that made himself look better. Like, wow, the dog didn't get pushed, but you didn't exactly try and take every precaution to make sure homie didn't get cut in half by a blade. Like, where is homie's life jacket? Why was he not anchored to the boat in some way, shape, or form while you were actively moving?
I don't know, bro. Maybe I overthink stuff too much. Maybe I'm too scared. Maybe I'm a fat puss, but I would kind of like to secure my dog to the boat to make sure he didn't jump off while we were actively moving. I feel like that's just a smart pet owner thing to do. You know, if you're in a moving vehicle of any kind, make sure the dog is safe and secure. Even if it's just, you know, making sure the windows aren't rolled down while you're going 70 miles an hour on the highway.
Yeah, that's right. I'm definitely judging you people. Why you going 80 in the fast lane and your dog's head hanging out the side of the window? You changed lanes wrong and its head getting chopped off. Irresponsible ass motherfucker.
All right, my gripes with how horrible a lot of pet owners are. What do you guys think, alright? Is he guilty? Is he innocent? Is Logan Paul actually my secret baby daddy and I'm about to give birth to his child? I don't know. That's up for you guys to decide.
Seriously though, if you guys enjoyed this video, drop a fat like on it. And if you're new, subscribe. I'd really appreciate that. Also, make sure to check out all the links in the description. Twitch, Twitter, Discord, Instagram, blah, blah, blah. Shameless self-promotion. You guys know the drill.
Also, moral of this video is make sure you keep your guinea pigs on a leash. Because if you don't get your guinea pig on a leash, then it will get turned into guinea pig bacon. No joke, no scam. Anyways, I really hope you guys are all having a fantastic day, night, whenever you're watching this. I've been Lofi. Peace out, broskis.